Good afternoon, and here we are with our session on positive mental attitude. This is used very often in management jargon. People are told that you really want to achieve something, you must have a positive mental attitude. But it's not that easy and it's not that simple. So let me go into the roots of this concept. See, every child is born positive. Child starts with wanting to explore the world, wanting to learn, wanting to grow and evolve. And that is how the thoughts are also programmed. Thoughts of children and, of course, you know, adults who have this positive mental attitude think in terms of wanting to do something good, wanting to achieve, wanting to be loved, wanting to have good relationships. So the more our thoughts go into the positive realm, the more it becomes like an attitude or a way of life. So there are those who say that this glass is half full, and there are those who say this glass is half empty. Nobody's glass is totally full. All that we get in life is varying, sometimes 20%, sometimes 90%. But do I look at the positive things or the negative things? Sometimes, without realizing, our elders, you know, push that negativity into us. It's very unfortunate if anyone grows up being, with good intentions, told that you are no good, you cannot achieve, you are not doing well. I in fact know of parents whose child gives an exam, gets the answer paper which says that he got 92%. And the parent looks at it and says, why did you lose these 8 marks? Why did you make these stupid mistakes? Because of which you lost out 8 marks. Here is a child who has got 92%, and the parent is drilling negativity into the child. So what happens when this child grows up? If he's hardworking, if he's intelligent, he'll keep getting his 90, 92, 95, whatever it is. But his thinking process becomes negative. Anything that he does, he gets an increment and he says, why only this much increment? I should have got more. He builds a house and he says, oh, this house is not big enough. I should have had a bigger house. So like that, some of us get negativity sort of, you know, imbibed into us. And even if we are achieving something, what happens is we can only look at the negative things that are happening. So today we are going to talk about how to consciously make the necessary efforts to ensure that we have an attitude, a thinking which is positive. If I start doing that, over a period of time, it becomes like a habit. And then I don't have to worry at all. I don't have to think and consciously make efforts. There are innumerable people I know who are very optimistic, who always think positively. And they have one more secret, let me tell you that. They take others with them. Those who want to achieve, want to be great in life, but they want to do that by suppressing others, by climbing over people's shoulders. What happens to them? The others start putting them down. And when others put me down, obviously I develop a negative attitude. I become confrontationist. I start doubting my own capabilities. And regardless of what I am doing, how much I am achieving, my mind remains negative. In order to ensure that I have a positive attitude, one of the first things which I really believe in to a great extent is that I must take charge of my life. People who pass the buck, who blame others for anything bad happening to me, they develop a very negative attitude. Those who say, if I'm getting something good in life, I have worked for it. If something bad has happened to me, it is because of my mistakes. So people who decide that I will take charge of my life, it's my life and I will take charge of it. One way of doing that is a very simple technique, which I keep practicing and teaching others also, particularly, let's say, in our Manthan camps. That is what we call as creative visualization. Learn to visualize. Learn to dream. Learn to fantasize. I remember long back we used to have an electrician, young boy, who used to come on a small little moped, the tiniest of two-wheelers. And on the back of that, he had put a sticker, "My other vehicle is a Mercedes-Benz." People used to laugh at it, but that was his attitude. Okay, one fine day somebody asked him, "Hey dude, where is your other vehicle, the Mercedes-Benz? I don't see it." And he said, "It is parked in my mind." You get me? A person who cannot even afford a proper two-wheeler is obviously not very well off. But he dreams of that Mercedes. And he parks it in his mind. And you know something? It's not important whether eventually he gets his Mercedes or not. He is actually enjoying driving a Mercedes in his own fantasy world. There's been a lot of research or surveys, whatever you want to call it, about people successful in management. Regardless of which field you are in. You're a technocrat, you're a finance person, you're a legal person, you're a communication person, whatever it may be. It is estimated that initially, your first progress, your first few steps are based on your skills, whichever function you are in. If you're an IT person, then your skills on programming or computers or whatever it is. If it is finance, then your skills with numbers and calculations and whatever it is. But as you go up the ladder, it has been shown that 80% of your success, 80% of what you actually achieve, depends not on your professional or technical skills, but on your attitude. So keep this in mind. And the same thing applies to good relationships. As a counselor, I deal with a lot of people, who have difficulties in relationships. It could be marital, it could be parent-child, it could be with your colleagues or boss or whoever it may be. I have seen that those who have good relationships are the people with a positive attitude. They look upon every relationship with a feeling that I want to do something about it. One of my favorite authors is Wayne Dyer, W-A-Y-N-E, D-Y-E-R. Can you put that up on this? W-A-Y-N-E-D-Y-E-R. Amazing writer. He has written at least half a dozen bestsellers, exemplary books, everything to do with human behavior. One simple formula of his is, I'm not getting anything on the chat. Is it coming?
Yeah, I
put
the chat.
Mm-hmm.
I put the chat.
Ah, good, it knows. Sorry. Yeah, good to see all the hellos and good afternoons and all that. I was missing that. Something was wrong with my chat box, but now I can see. And a collective good afternoon and hello to all of you. Right. So Vendayer says, never be against something. Always be for something. What does that mean? I am doing well in my work. A new boss turns up and he is nasty to me. If I say, I want to run away from this boss, I don't like this boss, what happens? I will land up from the frying pan to the fire. If I say, I am a competent and qualified person, I have been doing good work, I know my abilities, but currently, whether it's because of the boss or because of any reason, I'm not being able to flourish. I'm not being able to rise to my full potential. So what do? I will look for a better job. It's the same thing. The action is the same, that I'm quitting this job and going for another job. But the attitude in the first case is, I can't tolerate this boss, I want to run away from him. The attitude in the second case is, I will do something to ensure that I am in a better environment. These are very simple but highly effective examples of how you can, you know, actually achieving by having a positive mindset. There's another factor to it which not too many people give importance to, and that is, when you want to achieve something, when you want, it could be something very simple, like I want to clean out my drawer or my closet. It could be that I need some clothes and I need to take out time, go and buy it. It could be that my uncle, whom I love and respect very much, is not keeping good health. He lives in another city. I want to go and visit him and inquire about him and come back. Anything, whatever may be the task on hand, check yourself whether you are procrastinating, meaning to say postponing without any valid reason. Now, if I have to go and meet my uncle, but I'm in a busy work or I have got responsibilities of my family, so I say, not now, maybe I'll go in the Dasara vacation. That's fine. That's not procrastination. But postponing without any reason, or worse than that, creating some reasons which are not there. Actually, I'm feeling a little tired nowadays, so taking that journey will tire me more. I'll get a little better and then I will go. Or these days, every evening it has been raining, and if I go in this rain and all that, it will be difficult. So I'll wait for a few days, maybe the rains will stop. These are only excuses. I'm creating reasons for not going, and that is what we call as procrastination. There's another factor that helps you to develop a positive mindset, particularly when you are facing something which is uphill. I want to achieve something which seems to be very difficult. I don't know whether I will achieve that at all. One simple way is to break it up into smaller goals. So I have to achieve this big thing. But my first goal right now is to take this one step forward. There's a wonderful proverb, you would have all heard of it. Even a 1,000-mile journey begins with the first step. People who sit thinking, I have to travel 1,000 miles. Whew, it's so difficult. Will I be able to do it? What will happen on the way? What will be the hurdles? But if I say, right now I will take one step. So, now my destination is 1,000 miles minus 3 feet. That's how life goes. There are a lot of very, very simple things by which, you know, we can work towards building this type of a temperament or this type of a attitude. So I asked the girls in our office to enact a small little skit. And Anis, who is generally always behind the camera, today you will actually see her in this little skit of how a positive mental attitude helps you in life.
Hi Anis! Oh, hi Kanaka! How are you? It's so long, you know, so
yes,
long.
Yeah.
Yeah? Yes. Hey, sit, no sit, we will chat. It's been really long chatting with you.
Are yaar, I have a presentation in the office here. They just called me, they told me I have to come and give the presentation. And see, it's going to rain also. I really don't know, you know, how I'm going to reach the office with this rain and the presentation. I really don't know what to do now.
Anis, you never know, it can get postponed also. And you might get some time for preparations. This says a message for you.
Oh yeah, let me check. Oh yes, see, my boss has sent a message saying there is presentation postponed for tomorrow.
Ah, yeah. Such a relief. Now,
yes,
you can prepare also and chit chat with me also, okay? Let's order some chai and bhaji.
Yes, done. We'll do that.
I'm feeling very thirsty.
Are Kanaka, you still have this? Hey, why don't you change this bottle here? Yeah? See how it has become?
Anis, this is the new abstract art, Anis. And my bottle is like, it is like this, no, nobody will steal also. So I've kept it. And the bottle is safe with me from yours.
Yes. You've seen how it is primarily attitude. Situation remains the same. Good things happen, bad things happen. But how do you look upon those things? That is what is very important. You know, as I was mentioning right in the beginning, as children, most of us have a positive attitude. In fact, the positive attitude goes beyond what we call as rational thinking. If a child is told, no, you cannot go to Chennai and meet your favorite auntie, you have school, we'll see in the holidays. So this child sitting over here looks at the roof of the house and says, you know what I'll do? I'll cut a hole in the roof and I will raise myself up, fly outside that hole, go into the sky, turn towards southeast and zoom, I will go to Chennai. I look at auntie's house, come down, cut another hole in her roof, go down and tell auntie, give me my favorite sweet and she'll give it to me. I will eat that, then I'll go up, close the roof in her house, come back to my house, close the roof here, and then I will sit and do homework. And the child actually experiences the joy of tasting her favorite aunt's sweet. So one thing I'd like to tell you, if you truly want to retain that childlike, you know, positive mental attitude. Keep your inner child alive. Don't take yourself too seriously as an adult. Think of the lighter things in life. You know those songs, both in English and in Hindi, we shall overcome. We shall overcome one day. Hum honge kamyab ek din. When is that one day and ek din going to come? Sometimes it may never come lifelong. How does it make a difference? You're already enjoying it, no? When you say, we shall overcome, hum honge kamyab, you automatically feel nice. And you start experiencing the joys of overcoming and being kamyab. And this, nobody can take away from you. People can control your body, your limbs, but people cannot control your thought. And thoughts lead to feelings, isn't it? By now, most of you, I'm sure we have drilled it into you that all our thoughts lead to our emotions or feelings. So when we start thinking positive thoughts, we start developing happy feelings. We start actually experiencing that joy, fulfillment, satisfaction, whatever name you want to give it, without actually having the material things that we aspire for. And when you develop a positive mental attitude, you know, one thing you do is you start bringing in change even when there is no need. You know what negative people do? They become complacent. They want to stick to their comfort zone. They don't want to experiment with something. They don't want to take risks. And one fine day, something goes wrong. I'm so complacent in my job, I don't even want to think what better I can do, and one fine day I lose my job. Whenever anything like that happens, it becomes very difficult to then start putting in the effort. See, if you've got a huge building or factory or auditorium or something, one of the things that you do is to buy fire extinguishers, because you say if and when a fire breaks out, I am ready for it. I just pull that extinguisher out from the wall and spray the foam and the fire is gone. So I'm not scared of fires, I'm there. But what about those who are complacent? Hey, fire extinguishers are very expensive. What's the point in investing so much? I've already invested so much in the structure. I'm running short of money. I'll wait. And then when the fire breaks out, can you go running to buy a fire extinguisher? No, no. That is what happens in life. So you can develop positive feelings if you have positive thoughts, which are entirely in your control. Similarly, always keep a note of your past experiences. That helps to a great extent, you know. In the past, I tried out this or I did that and it worked. I tried out this and I failed. When you recall that I did not succeed in something, it gives you the ability to think, maybe I can have the same goal but take a different path. I tried this path and there were too many hurdles and obstacles, so maybe I can take a slightly roundabout path and I will achieve what I couldn't achieve last time. Or I can set a different goal altogether. Either way, we have enough time. We have that peace of mind, calmness to start thinking of what I can do. But when things go bad, it becomes too late to bring about that change. One more important thing I thought I'd share with you. You know, positive attitude is contagious. People who have a negative thinking pattern, who are always thinking of the worst, they spread that type of attitude to others around them. You remember long ago when COVID came, we were warned that the infection spreads. Put on a mask. When you are with negative people, I would say, put on a mask on your mind. Do not allow that negativity to impermeate your mind. And as far as possible, keep that social distancing as we were cautioned. We were told to keep 2 meters social distancing. I would say, when you see negative people, keep a social distancing of not 2 meters, but 20 meters and 200 meters. Keep as far away from negative people and spend more and more and more time with positive people. It's not difficult to identify them. Just get into a conversation with somebody and you will see how it is. You saw in the skit where Kanaka and Anis were talking. What happened? One of the two friends had a very negative attitude. Now, if you have a friend like that, even if you have a family member like that, firstly, see if you can influence that person and bring about some positivity in that person. But if you realize that that is not happening, the reverse can happen. You can get influenced by that person. So once you have tried, then keep away. If you can physically keep away, nothing like it. If you cannot do it because it's a family member or somebody very close to you, in that case, keep a mental distance. Do not allow yourself to get influenced by their way of thinking. And if by chance they say some negative things, which is likely to influence you, move to the company of positive people and discuss the same thing with them. And when they give you a positive approach to the same issue, you know that there are two sides to the coin. And you start appreciating that I can think for myself. One person is trying to drill negativity into me. The other person is trying to build positivity. I will spend more time with this person. I will reflect and accept what this person is saying. Thereby, I will find myself developing my own positive attitude. Including even when things are going very wrong, there are dark clouds over you. As they say, look for the silver lining. Every dark cloud, they say, has a silver lining. And that is what happens in real life. So with that, let me take my 1 minute break. Purnima is here with you to just update you quickly on what's happening in Bandera and what you can do to build up a positive attitude.
Hello, hello. Good afternoon. Kaise ho aap log? Khana wana khaya? That's what they usually ask, right? In the afternoon hours. So if you have to build a positive attitude, the first thing that you can do is try and have a nice smile on your face. Even if somebody is a little smirky, no, you say that, jaane to, what to do? This man only knows so much. This girl only knows so much. So that itself, you know, kind of makes you feel a little lighter. So that is a little 2 pence from me. And I'm here also to give you some nice announcements. So break time is also announcement time, because we want you to feel and know what is happening at Banjara. And if in any which ways you want to contribute, being a part of the program or participating in the program, please feel free to do so, and we'll be more than happy. So yesterday we had a webinar which was on understanding different career choices in medicine and paramedical fields. So we are having a series of these things coming up. I'll just read out a few. It's there right here. See, Anis has put up the poster, but I'll just read it up for your benefit. So yesterday was the all those who would like to take up medicine, paramedical courses, and what are the different options. So Ali, and then we have domain specialists. So who can actually give us hands-on information of what's happening. Then on 25th of October, we are having finance and related fields. So if you know anyone, you know, who would want to have more information, or who would want to guide people with these kind of careers. So on the 25th of October, finance and related. Then in this same series, on the next one, which is coming up, is just 2-3 days before that, on 21st October, we are having a classroom session. So we give you an opportunity to come to our office at Banjara, Ati Nagar. So the posters and the Google form will be all out, because we would like to know how many you want to come, how to go about, payment details, QR codes, all of them will be there, all in one poster, in one shot. So this classroom session is going to be a career guidance workshop. It is going to be from say 10:30 to 2 o'clock with little lunch, little snacks, and lots of inputs and insights and notes from our end. So Ali will be steering it, and we, Sonal and I, you've met Sonal, na? Sonal and I will be again giving our little small bits of experiences that we have in this. So it is a classroom session, because we firmly believe that seeing face to face, experiencing that smile of yours in flesh and blood always works better, though this online is also a much better mode now to be in touch. So announcements will be coming in, posters are underway. So that is something which is going to come up later on. We are also going to be having in November a career webinar on design related careers. And in December, it is going to be on environment and ecology. So we are trying our bit to cover as much as possible, you know, the spectrum of careers. And a small bit, you all know, right? Counseling is free, face-to-face, telephonic, and you may even choose to, anyone may choose to write a mail also. Along with that, career counseling is also totally free. Anyone whom you know, who would like to understand, can be also retired people. From 58 to 85 years, they have 30 long years. So even there, they can choose to have a new career and a new second innings for themselves. So this is from our side of the break. And now for thoughts and questions, clarifications, discussions, interactions by you and with Ali. Over to Ali.
Okay, I'm seeing some interesting comments and questions. Anis will put them up. The first one is from Asha. Never be against something, be with them and walk parallelly we can build resilience, still smile, and keep moving ahead. Thanks for that, Asha. And I reinforce what I told you. People who want to achieve, people who want to do well in life, and they take others along with them, are the happiest and most successful. Surekha says, once in the fifth standard, I was mean-spirited and refused to share my notes with a fellow student. I remember my teacher's immortal words. If you think little and behave little, the results are likely to be little. But if you think big and behave big, the results are likely to be big. So be big is what the teacher told Surekha. This one thought has many a times helped me to move away from pettiness and to tap into the dimensions of my personal greatness. And that personal greatness, let me tell you, spreads to others also. Right? Okay. Roshan says, my father was always encouraging me, even if the alu bondas which I made were burnt, he would say, oh, wow, my darling has made such tasty bondas. He loved and pampered me so much that today my thoughts are always positive and love to encourage and motivate others. This is very important. Today, I have started a needlecraft group in the Secunderabad club where we make something and donate it to the needy. Everyone is happy doing what they are passionate about, and the thought that this will be donated to the sick or the needy people gives you a greater sense of fulfillment. Right. Surekha also says, I once met a lady in a metro cabin. She asked all of us cheerfully, how are you all doing today? Isn't it a beautiful day? I asked her, what makes you ask with such great joy? You know what she answered? I used to be the most miserable woman in Bangalore. But one day, I found life and realized that there was no other reason to celebrate life other than life itself. And by the time she got out, she had made all of us happy that we were alive and able to celebrate life. There's another very good proverb which says, some people keep complaining about the weather. Other people create their own weather. This was a wonderful example of that. Okay. Surekha says, I will always remember my mother's message to me. Love other people. Do the best you can and put your faith in God. Keep it simple. I feel her words were the secrets of security in an insecure world. And if you get such words in your childhood, no, you always grow up to be a positive thinking adult. Similarly, Surekha is adding, it is a positive mental attitude that many a time pulls us out of the rut. At times when I feel a little laid back, about 100-year-old, labor-intensive type of crispy chucklies, and would want to put it off, the positive thought that pushes me forward is, if I don't do these chucklies, in some time, I may forget about them. And then this recipe will die with me. I want more and more people to enjoy my chucklies, handed down to me by generations. This positive thought of keeping that slice of me keeps us going. There was that story, I don't know whether you remember, I had mentioned this long back also. It is called the Jack the Donkey. there was an empty well in a farm, and Jack the donkey fell into that well. It was so deep that he couldn't jump out of it. And the farmer and the others were wondering how to get Jack out. See, if it was a human being, they could have thrown a rope. The person would have caught the rope and they could have pulled him out. But he's a donkey. What do you do? How do you get him out? They tried all possible things. A huge meeting took place with all the farmers collecting there, and they all gave up. And then they said, nothing can be done. Jack is going to die. But you know what they realized? That Jack, living down in their deep, empty well, will starve to death over days and weeks. Every day he will suffer from hunger, from pain, from, you know, debilities. And he'll die such a miserable death. So you know what they decided? They said, let us bury Jack alive so that within a few hours he will be dead. He'll have a peaceful end. So all the farmers got shovels and they started pouring mud over him. But you know what Jack did? Every time the mud would fall, he would shake the mud and climb over it. As the mud kept falling, Jack started climbing higher and higher. At one point, there was so much mud that he could climb high enough to jump out from there and come out onto the open ground. Now that comes out of an attitude which says that even if mud is being thrown at me to bury me alive and to kill me, I can still use it as a means to rise above and escape. And the same thing happens in real life. It's just a question of our own attitude. As long as I can think positively, whether you are in a ditch or a deep well, whether you are going through the most so-called miserable time in life, whatever it may be, it is your attitude which actually gives you ideas, paths, and means to be able to overcome whatever you are going through and to be able to move towards a better quality of life. And once you do that, always remember such incidents. Never forget them. I know what a bad time I was having. I know how miserable I was. I know I was thinking that this is the end and things will only go down from here. But I did it. I used my mind. I used my positive attitude, and thereby I came up. So tomorrow, if a completely different problem strikes me, if something totally unexpected hits me, I will have the attitude that yes, I can overcome it. Keep that in mind, keep practicing it. And like I told you, it is contagious. Keep spreading it to other people. Teach those who are negative to think positively. Like Purni said, when you see somebody without a smile, you know, give him one of yours. And when you have happier and more positive people around you, your happiness, your joy, and your positivity keeps constantly increasing. So with that little message, I will leave you to your weekend. And we shall meet again next Saturday, which is 28th of September, where we are going to talk about how anger can actually be very useful. We talk about anger in a very negative way, no? We don't want to have anything to do with anger. But come out with your own ideas, your experiences. We will discuss on 28th September at 2 o'clock. How we can make, because anger is natural, anger is built into any one of us. It's one of the strong emotions, one of the core emotions. But how we manage that anger and how we make it useful is what we are going to discuss. And the week after that, it's going to be unfinished emotional business. And then there is the Dasara festival on 12th of October, so we take a gap. And 19th October, we are going to be talking about how to deal with depression. I'm looking forward to having you all with us on all these Saturdays. Thank you and bye-bye.
Nobody will steal also. So I've kept it. And the bottle is saving me from yours.